Okay, so I'm looking here to see if I have any errors. Well, it looks like I forgot braces here for DQ, so I'm calling that method correctly now. So now I'm just going to go ahead and go through my test cases that I mentioned before. I'm just going to put them in this little box here. And we had our none, our empty brackets. So when we go through these return zero immediately, so that's working. And what about when we actually have a working test case that goes through most of this code here? Okay, so I go through, set islands to zero, checking the length. So this would be set to 3, and this would be 2. So going through every element. So when I find my first one, I'm incrementing my island count. So now that's going to be equal to 1. And I go to my find parts of island method here, creating my queue, appending those values, and then I have my breadth first search here that I'm going through. And so for this instance, there's no 1 to the right or on the bottom of it. So I wouldn't have to do this. And then I go to the next one. It's not 0, so we don't do anything. We just go through the loop. 1. Okay, so I'm going to increment my island count again. This is now going to be 2. And so then I go through that, and then I find my parts on the island. So there actually are ones here, so I'm going to go ahead and add those. Then I add those there, and that looks all good. And so this one actually gets set to 2 there, and this is going to get set to 2. And now I'm adding both of these to the queue to look at them. And I'm not appending any of the stuff around there. I'm only appending that to the queue. So going looking through there, there's nothing else. And so basically, I'm just going to be setting these to 2. And then I'd probably just visit every element in the array. There's no more 1s, so that would be the end of it. But oh, it looks like I forgot to return the number of islands here. So it looks like it works. Well, it looks like all of his code worked. Not only is this fellow handsome, but he sure is intelligent.
The debugging process is often overlooked, but a very important part of the algorithm interview. Not only does this show the interviewer that the candidate checks their code, it may even help the candidate find mistakes that they missed the first time they were coding their solution. It's easy to miss a semicolon here and there if a candidate were coding in some language like Java, or forget to return a result.